Now, in South Africa, in the course of the last hour or so, supporters of Julius Malema, head of the ANC's Youth League, have been throwing stones and bottles at police ahead of a scheduled disciplinary hearing against the leader. Police have responded with rubber bullets and tear gas. Well, these clashes come ahead of what's expected to be a major political showdown, as the man who's been tipped as a possible president faces charges of bringing the ANC into disrepute after he called for regime change in neighbouring Botswana. We can speak to our correspondent Karen Allen, who joins me on the line now from Johannesburg. Karen, first of all, the scale of the troubles outside this hearing.
Well, certainly several hundreds of protesters tried to encircle the street where the ANC headquarters is, and they were met by volleys of stun grenades from the police. They were firing those to try and disperse the crowd. The crowd responded by throwing back bottles, hurling rubbish bins and overturning rubbish bins, some even setting alight T-shirts with the visage, with the image of President Jacob Zuma on it. It gives you a real sense about tempers being raised here, because this isn't simply about a hearing, a disciplinary hearing for Julius Malema. It is about the fate of the ANC, in particular the fate of President Jacob Zuma, because he faces an important leadership contest within the party next year, and Julius Malema is seen as an impediment to him possibly being able to secure a second term. Things have calmed down a little more now. I'm just a few hundred meters away from the crowds, where they are chanting anti-Zuma slogans and pro-Julius songs. So temperatures have been raised, but they've calmed down a little more. We're certainly not going to hear very much from this closed-door hearing for today, possibly an appearance by Julius Malema later to address the crowd, but at the moment things are calm.
It does give us, doesn't it, Karen, an extraordinary picture of the what is, after all, the all-powerful ANC, and just how fragile perhaps it is from within.
Absolutely. I mean, certainly this is an internal dispute within the ANC. There's no question about it. A government change within South Africa, given the huge majority that the ANC commands. But nevertheless, there are internal power struggles. Julius Malema has been putting issues, for example, of nationalization and land distribution onto the agenda. He claims to be supporting and articulating the views of the vast numbers of young unemployed people in South Africa. Unemployment is more than 30% here. But there are other people who are saying, you know, Julius Malema has a different agenda. He has powerful backers within the party and within the business community. There's a separate set of investigations going on, looking at his own business dealings after a number of exposés in the press questioning whether backhanders were being paid. Those are being investigated, as I say, separately. But what we're seeing today is a flavour of ructions within the party, and a fair amount of distaste towards not only Julius Malema, but also President Zuma himself.
Karen, thank you very much indeed. Karen Allen with the latest there from Johannesburg.